No, Sibusiso, you are telling us that you don't even have one kid. The answer is, I don't have. What are you waiting for, girl? For my future husband. What if he doesn't come? Definitely he will come. Those wait upon the Lord will never be put to shame, the Bible says. So guys, let's talk about pressure from people, my friends, family. Everyone is just asking me the same question every day. When are you having kids?
Well,
do you have anything to say?
Well, I have a lot, but considering that, honestly, but I will just shorten it. You know, I know exactly where you've been, or you are going through. I'm 35. In fact,
you are 35.
I'm 35. Wow. Yes.
Praise the Lord.
But this, and actually this month I'm turning 36.
Can wow. You imagine? Praise the Lord. Yeah.
I'm just like you. I don't have a child.
Wow.
I'm not married. I'm staying at home.
Wow.
You know. Hustling to make a living is not easy. So
yeah,
for me, I always say that when you're single, you know, I'm single as well.
Yeah.
So
and you've been single like for
this
many years.
My eighth year single, waiting upon the Lord.
Wow.
Yes.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Testimony is coming.
Amen to that. Amen.
Yeah, it is coming.
Amen. Mm. And it's not easy, you know. It's something that, you know, it's an everyday thing. You can't say, oh, someone's waiting upon the Lord, you know. You know, sometimes people deceive, they just talk like, oh, it's easy. It's not. You need the grace. It's actually something that you have to ask a daily, you know, a prayer that you have to pray every day. God, give me the strength, give me the grace to continue holding on. And people are not even making it easy by pressurizing us, you know.
Yeah.
Just like you.
Yeah.
You are 31. For me, I'm like, she's so young. She still has a lot to do. But still, already now, people are asking me, when are you getting married? Why don't you have a child? I don't think that's something that we need to hear as a single woman.
It's not. I will end up like, if there's no grace, like, and we'll end up like doing this interesting afternoon concerns, like having kids. Sing up play now just because of people.
Mm. But for me, you know, I believe that if you know what you want and you always look back, for me, I always have this reminder in my mind that Brenda, you've been through a lot. You have waited. Don't waste your life or don't waste your years on based on what people are saying. People's opinions, whether you do good or bad, people always talk.
Mm.
If now, for example, I decide, okay, let me just fall pregnant and have a child. People will still talk, oh, she waited all these years, now she just decided, and the father is not even married to her, or something like that. So for me, I'd rather do what is pleasing to me, wait. And then I know that it's not easy, but I know that God who is with me, or who's been with me throughout, is going to see me through, and I will testify.
Very soon, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I'll invite you very soon.
Yeah, and I'll invite you to my
with you. Your husband, you will be sharing your testimony, and
yes.
So like I think there's another lady who asked me, Ruti, why like you don't have a child at your age, maybe you've been doing abortions. I'm telling you, just like I was like,
you know, like I said, people always have an opinion about your life, and I think even with age, you get mature to the extent that you know what you want. You know that nobody can tell me how to live my life, and my choices are my choices. You know, I've been in a situation where I've been told, Brenda, you are barren. Brenda, you said that maybe you are cursed.
Yeah.
You are bewitched. And I've been warned that, you know, what do you think you're waiting for? What if that person never comes? And then there are times that even people around me, you know, and you know when something like this, especially when you're waiting upon God for your husband, you're waiting for your, you know, like you wait for that husband, you know that, okay, this is the person that I want them to be the father of my kids. And sometimes people will ask you, like I was asked once that, what do you think that person is going to come from? Or because God can even send someone, that person will give you a child and go. And I told them, you know what, I'm not going to have to start thinking about this and that and this and that. I know my God. And God promised that anyone that waits upon him, he will never be put to shame. So I know that when the time comes, I will have my godly husband, and then I will have my children with him. So they will tell you everything.
When the time is right, I, the Lord, will make it happen.
Praise.
Amen.
Amen. You will, and you will perfect it.
Amen.
And God said, I will never, ever abandon you, or never leave you, nor forsake you. and you are projecting God's hands. So God is actually working on you on a daily basis. So for you to actually divert from what God is working on and start your own thing,
yeah,
you're making a mistake. Because believe it or not, for us singles, when we look at people who are married, we have that thing, okay, fine, yes, we want this, one, this, but you don't know the basis, the foundation of their marriages. You don't know what, how they got there.
Mm-hmm.
So don't always look at someone and say, oh my gosh, she's 29, she's 25, she's married and everything. Sometimes get to know that person, you'll be saying, okay, my God, you know what, I'm thankful that you kept me at 35, at 30.
Yeah.
I'm not married because I don't want that. Nobody's perfect. No marriage is going to be perfect. Even ours,
yeah,
even though we waited, we're still going to have challenges. But I believe most of the time, what is preserved by God, even if the challenges, you actually know how to.
Yeah.
You naturally, I think you're equipped for you to fight those challenges more than someone who doesn't even know,
yeah,
who have no experience as well.
What a topic. Let's wait. We keep on waiting. Let's do this. We'll wait because you know what? If we don't wait,
mm-hmm, I think I told you this before, as we always talk about it, is that there are people who are actually looking up to you.
Wow.
You know, there are people looking up to you, you know them. There are people who look up to you, you don't know them. The moment you divert from this road, this way of waiting and this way of saying, God, I'm waiting for this and I'm waiting for you, there are people that, of course, you tell,
yeah,
you know, who knows you are very close to. Those people are actually looking at you, watching you, they may not see it. The moment you give up, the moment you say, okay, you know what, I'm done waiting, let me just get a man and have a child. Trust me, you have disappointed many people. Yes, you're not living for them, but there are young ones who are looking up to you, say that if my sister can do this, if my friend can do this,
mm-hmm,
if my cousin can do this, Lisa can do it as well. That is why I always believe, just be honest, tell them that it's not an easy thing, but it's possible. There are people who have waited for 30 years, there are people who have waited for 20 years, and God rewarded them with what they've been waiting for, and God answered them. So if they can do it, so can we. And if we can do it, so those girls who are literally looking up to,
yeah,
you, they will do it.
I needed to hear this, girl.
Because I'm telling you, it's not gonna be easy.
It's not.
It's gonna be worth
those days. Like, I feel like I wish I had someone. Maybe if I can have a kid.
And there's a time that, you know, you look at your friends and everything, they have that, they have this, like, oh God, if I can have, you know, maybe, you know, what should I say? Should I say flowers and things like that? But for me, I always go back to say that, you know what, God, I need those things as maybe, you know, the flesh will need you to have,
yeah,
you know, someone that can talk to you, companion and something like that. But in the end, I always go back to say, you know what, I'm not going to do something just for that moment. They don't want an instant thing that just happened now. You know, temporary thing, that's the right word. I don't want a temporary person.
Mm-hmm.
I want someone that I know that's going to be permanent in my life, you know. So I'm not going to go in a place that I know that is going to be permanent. For example, now, you waited for years,
mm-hmm,
you decide to say, you know what,
mm-hmm,
God, today, I just want to do this, and I do it, the next day you're ready. How's that?
I needed to hear this, girl.
I'm glad because it's something that even me, I needed to talk about it, and I,
yeah,
needed you to actually remind me that, mm-hmm, you know what, Brenda, you're still in the right path, you're still good. Because sometimes, you know, we don't have many friends that we can relate to.
Yeah.
Most of our friends, you know, they are married.
I think you should also check Ashley Empowers.
Mm-hmm.
She's a YouTuber.
Mm-hmm.
Now she's been waiting for years. Like, because I didn't see her abstaining, like,
mm-hmm,
from sex. And then they got married, I think, after a year.
Yeah.
They were dating, but no kata.
Yeah.
Yeah. And now, yeah, they are married with 2 kids.
Yeah, and in fact, you know what? What I realized before, I was like, because among my people, like my friends, when I see my people, most of my close friends, I'm like, I don't know anyone. And some people know someone who's like a few months, a year.
Yeah.
And I'm talking about the long term.
Yeah.
And then I say, no, I want to find out, am I the only one in this? So I want you to. I find a lady, I think her name is Amina. I'll send you a link.
Okay.
Yes, Amina, she's from UK. She's been waiting for the past 14 years.
Wow.
And she's like 30, she's my age. I think 35. So there are many people They might not talk about it, but there are many people. By that time when you're waiting, you're like, God, it's not the only one who's doing this thing.
Is he gonna come?
Or no, those moments come. You know, and those are
but if I wait and wait and wait. Mm-hmm. But even if I don't get married, that means I won't have a child, because I will never have a child without hard work.
Mm-hmm.
I will never.
No, that's the thing that you tell yourself, and that's the thing that I always tell myself. Whenever I love you, I love children. I'm an aunt. Even like I've got children, I have children all over. I mean, around me.
Yeah,
I'm telling you, you want those things. But the moment you think of a child or you see a child, even you envision your own child, you envision a ring in your finger, you envision a husband.
Yeah.
But this generation now is that having a child is
yeah, it's a fashion.
It is. Now when they look
but
at
people like, will always talk, because if you like you fall pregnant at 40, they will talk.
Yeah.
If you fall pregnant later, they will also talk.
They will talk. That's what I'm saying. Do you do what makes you happy? You know, there's a friend of mine that asked me from work. I remember last year he was like challenged by me. He was like, so you say you have no child? I said no. Even asked me, so you have never fell pregnant, like you don't know. I said no. Yeah. He's like, are you sure? I said, yeah, I'm positive. He's like, okay, can I ask you a question? I'm like, yeah. He said, okay. Look around your friends. Tell me anyone you know in your age you have no child. I said at the moment I can't see anyone. He was like, but that thing doesn't challenge you anyway. I'm like, and it's not challenging me. It's making me feel proud, because you know they make that choice, I'm making mine. You know, because you can't live on other people. Like, for example, now, Sissy, how are we going to look up to the child now if you just have a child with our own girlfriend or just anyone? Huh? There's nothing you can do. You have to just wait and still trust. You know what? Just keep on trusting God and believe in that. You started this journey with God, and no one started a journey with God and God will just abandon you. It's never possible.
Amen.
If you started, you're gonna surely finish it. What you say to God, that God, give me the strength and the grace.
Mm-hmm.
And then, you know, temptations will come, that's normal. But you always have, you know, just have the makeup of the word of God, your faith, and believe that even though it's gonna come, but I know that one day, God, what he said about me, it shall surely come to pass. And he said, God said that no one waits upon me and put to shame. No one.
Can you just offer a prayer?
I will.
All right.
Well, before anything, anyone that is watching this and waiting upon the Lord, my message to you is just keep on waiting. You know, don't give up because of what people are saying. End of the day, this is your life and your choices. And always know that when God starts something in your life, you will never stop our faith.
And
you always finish it. There will be troubles, there will be times that you feel like, God, I can't take it, I can't do it. But just go back on your knees and say, God, give me strength. Because if your goal is to see yourself in your husband's house, you know, like your God-given husband, wait. There's no point in pleasing your friends or doing something that, oh, because everybody's doing it, I'm going to do it. You don't know the outcome. The outcome may not be the same outcome that you have. Don't just try something that, you know, end of the day, you might wait for the rest of your life. So let me just pray for my sister and everybody that is watching this, or is going to watch this. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, we thank you for this opportunity. Thank you for my sister. I thank you, Father, even for today. We thank you for the grace. God, we know that it's not an easy thing to just read and something that we do see, but because of faith and believe in our God, we never leave no forsaken children, especially those who are living at home. We are particularly blessed. We know that God, what we have waited for, while baby has been God, we can give it to us and we can see it. We're going to have our own children in our husband's house.
Amen.
And we know that God, Father, you said that anyone that waits upon shall not be to shame. So no matter what people they will say or they will do, God will never go back. We will continue knowing that God gave the final say. And I know that God and all my sisters, even my brothers who are waiting upon you, Father, for their spouses, God supply grace and strength and knowledge, even wisdom, Father, to go about it. We know that people will come for the different men and women will come in this thing that are from you. But Father, give us the spiritual eyes to know. Give us, Father, the discernment we need to know which one belongs to you. So we listen to that and know that we all the way that we need. Thank you, Jesus, for answering my prayer. And thank you, God, that as we continue to wait for that miracle day, give us, Father, even for the glory, for the faith that you have given us. And even for the giving us, Father, to the prosperity and all kinds of our life, so that one will tell you the good thing that is happening for you. We know that you know the good God, your will, Father, shall prevail. Thank you, Jesus. Now forever, we pray.
Wow, thank you so much.
Thank you.
I love you.
I love you too. My black diamond.
She's so beautiful. You are beautiful too.
Thank you so much.
Oh wow!
Question:
how did we meet?
I think we met on Facebook. We met on Facebook, and I was so inspired by your. I remember your pictures. Like this Tosa girl, she's so gorgeous. She's black and beautiful. I remember the first time I saw you was like your skin. I was really dark when I was very young.
Yeah.
I miss my dark skin. I don't know why people want to bleach and do this, but I miss my dark skin. So when I saw you first, I'm like, she's so black and beautiful.
Oh,
and I contacted you and we just, I remember we spoke, we started picking Messenger.
Yeah.
And we're like this from there.
Our first date was last year, this time.
Yeah. Last year. You don't forget, really?
Yeah, last year, this time.
I came to your house, made you lunch and everything.
Thank you so much, guys, for watching. I hope you have enjoyed this video. Don't mind any. Facebook.
Oh, yes, yeah. I have Facebook. My Facebook. Anyone that send me a friend request, I'm Brenda Dixon. You're gonna see a beautiful woman. They just
okay. Thank you. I hope I'll have you very soon again.
I hope so too.
All right.
I always just enjoy your company and thank you so much for having me.
Bye, guys.
Bye. God bless.